My pleasure to introduce Muinuddin Sarkar. He is a PhD and a Vice President for Research and Development with Natural Trade Research, Inc. Mr. Sarkar, welcome. You have done amazing research, especially trying to convert the plastic into fuel. And we have a lot to talk about. Let's just start about the technology. How do we convert that?
By thermal cracking. What we are doing, we are using some sort of outside heat and making melt and vaporize the plastic from melt paper, and then paper is traveling with the tube and product due to the condensation and product to keep it.
No, we all keep hearing about the waste, and you're just now mentioning to me about the CNN report where we had huge sizes of double than the size of Texas of plastic floating in Pacific Ocean. So these are some real concerns that need to be addressed, and
yes,
a lot of people trying to address it, but maybe the right solution is still missing. So, you know, can you elaborate on that?
I think there is a lot of people are working with the technology last 10 years or just a decade, but their technique and my technique is different because our technique is so simple. Whenever you are talking about the commercial perspective view, economic perspective view, everybody wants to see that the process is so simple, cost effective, and environment friendly. So we are focusing 3E. It means cost effective, high efficient, environment friendly. So we are consistent. Okay. Some of the people are using under Bikram, under catalysis, and then pyrolysis, anything, but it's all cost involved. So that's why we are not using anything. We're just using the simple process, and we like to work with existing recycling company or recycling facility, so we're not going to add any cost. So that's, 1980, the company BASF, German company, they opened this type of thermal cracking or pyrolysis in German. But due to the cost of the energy import or output at that time, due to the economy situation, they shut down and closed the system because that time the oil price was not big issue. Okay, and the energy waste was not the big issue. Right now, oil price is hiking. And the environmental prospect, present government in U.S. and trying to focus on the environmental issue, economic prospect, boosting the economy and creating lots of jobs. So if we convert all U.S. plastic, which is I think approximately 30 million metric tons of plastic, okay, if we utilize our technology all over U.S., we can create 60,000 to 100,000 jobs.
But let me take it to a layman's terms for an ordinary consumer to understand what you do. Let's say we collect about 5 pounds of plastic waste every month, and if we give it to the recycling, like every household would do it, how do we convert that into the fuel they're talking about, and how many pounds of plastic waste is required to convert, say, let's do a gallon of fuel?
I think I need that. This is my laboratory scale or my primary estimation or calculation. I need 3 kilogram of the plastic to make 1 gallon. But that 1 gallon is 3.8 liter. Okay, so if you give me 1 tons of plastic, I can make 8 to 9 barrels. But that barrel is 1 barrel equal to 42 gallon. But the crude oil barrel is different. Crude oil barrel is for 20 gallon.
So it's twice the capacity then?
Twice the capacity.
So where will this fuel be used, or where could it be used?
You can use any big bay. The beauty of the technology, you don't need to change the engine. It works for any internal combustion engine. So you can use for home heating, you can use for lawnmower, you can use for bus, truck, helicopter, airlines, and any sort of internal, and if you put it into the generator or turbine engine, it produces electricity. So you can light your house or, but most of our client will be city, municipality, and Department of Energy, big corporate office where, you know, our U.S. has a base, and cruise, you know, whenever you cruise is going to ocean, how much plastic they're taking with them. They need a milk bottle, contain, you know, water, jam, jelly, butter, wrapping system, especially, you know, Navy, whenever they're sending the frigate in the ocean. How much plastic they're taking with them, because they need to have to keep the marine corps or those people to keep healthy. They have to supply all the, you know, good food. So those, but after it's been used, it's a huge problem.
Right. But for the consumer to understand, so I'm going to come back to the entrepreneurship in the end. For the consumer to understand, the fuel could, so if large-scale industries or nations, mostly in the developing nations where there's a huge need for this kind of technology, if they come together and they produce this fuel, and you think that could be purchased by consumers at a subsidized rate compared to the regular fuel cost?
Yes, because as I said, I can make it less than 50 cents a gallon, but right now you are using $3 a gallon, okay? But even if you sell it $1, still you are have a margin.
Good.
Okay, and suppose right now the government is saying that, okay, they need to say a hybrid car. But hybrid car, you need a recharging facility, because you have the lifetime of the battery. And if the battery is down, then you have to recharge. So we have a plant where we can make the fuel and produce that fuel, put it into the turbine engine, and we can have a recharging facility. So people can come and recharging their battery and then go back to their daily activity. And also every municipality, city, they have a police car, ambulance, fire brigade, and they have a school bus. There is a lot of school community or a school board, they have to shut down school because they don't have money for their heating the school. So they can use those type of fuel to produce, you know, heating their whole school.
So let me now ask you the $1 billion question, which is, what does it cost to start this? What funding do you need? And how can entrepreneurs who want to get into this technology and, you know, use this, leverage this, for the benefit of themselves and for the society, how can they get involved?
We are open for every investor, community, city, and municipality, federal government, everybody, because we like to build a partnership with everybody, because it's not a one-way process. It's just everybody has to get involved. So federal government, state government, municipality, entrepreneur, and investor, okay. So I'm going to say to build a plant is depend how much it's going to cost, depend how much plastic you want to feed it onto the system. We can scale up from half tons to million tons. Okay? So it depend on the city or municipality or that state, how much plastic they wanted to put it into the system. And existing recycling facility, they are saying that no, there is a 7 code of the plastic, just say, okay, 1, 2, 3, HDP, LDP, or whatever. But the existing recycling facility say, no, we going to have number 3 or 4, I'm giving the example, is get our value than making the conversion. But then we're going to say, no, just like it, but there is some plastic they cannot convert at all. I can come up some idea, maybe that might not going to work. So what we wanted to sit down with them, negotiate with them, and see how is the best way to utilize this technology to bring this society up, create lots of jobs, boosting the economy, and reduce the foreign dependency, and reduce the carbon footprint, reduce the, because we have to leave this universe for our next generation, our children, grandchildren. Okay, so we have to do something for this society. This is actually the way we want it to work.
Dr. Sarkar, thank you for sharing your thoughts. You're doing awesome work. Thank you.
Thank you, and it was my pleasure.